Hey, what's going on, guys? Today I'm going to be doing a video about something I did to my helmet. That if you guys are doing airsoft and recording and you're wearing a helmet, these are some of the things that big airsofters do when they're wearing a helmet and just when they're doing it to play like quick games and stuff, because it makes it a lot easier. So on this side, there's really nothing new at all besides I have a patch over here. I don't think I had my last video, but if I flip it over, you guys can see that there's a wire running through here and there's a wire into my GoPro. Now, some of you tech people out there who do camera stuff might know that that is actually a power cord that is going to my GoPro. So what normally happens is I can actually record 4 hours of gameplay on my GoPro, but with my battery, I can only record about 30 minutes of video on my GoPro because my battery will end up dying. Now, there's pros and cons to this depending on what you're doing. There's more pros than there are cons because this is really good. Because when I would record, my GoPro would end up dying and sometimes in the middle of the game, and we would end up having to stop the game or just keep going and I wouldn't get that gameplay out of it. Now with this, I don't have to worry about that because my GoPro is always plugged in and I'm wearing a battery pack on the back of my hat or my helmet back here in this pouch. So it's just routed back into here. I don't have a battery pack in here because I'm working on getting a smaller one, because you want them to kind of counterbalance each other. The one I have in or had in there to test this out actually was too big and it was actually weighing the back of my helmet down, and you want it to kind of the GoPro to be the majority of the weight, and you want a little bit of weight on the back so the GoPro actually hangs down and leaves a little bit of weight on the front of your head. You don't want it to be like, oh, your battery pack's too heavy and your GoPro's too light, so then you have to put more weight on your GoPro. Because the more weight you add, the more strain it's going to put on your head, which means you're probably going to end up getting headache and not want to be playing for really long games. So you're going to want to have a little battery pack, but you want it to have enough power that it's going to keep your GoPro charged, or at least keeping it charged, so then if the battery pack dies, that your GoPro battery will last long enough. Now, what I had to do with mine was, this was actually my waterproof case that I have. I actually have two other ones. This is the reason why I did this to this. Now, when I play, my GoPro would end up dying while we're in the middle of a game. So what I did was I actually just took a drill and cut three holes out here, and then took the drill bit and did some working around with it, but then got it so that my cord will actually fit in to the charging port right here. Now, if you have an actual GoPro, they make ones that are actually cut out with a port on the side already, because they're actual GoPro and that's what they're made for, so you can do charging and like stuff with that, because that's what normally you'll see people do. But with this, since it's not an actual GoPro, it's just an action camera, is I just had to cut out of my waterproof case a spot, so then my cord will just go and plug in. You want it with mine, I have mine a little snug, so my cord's not going to wobble out in the middle of a game. If I get like, if the game gets really rowdy when I'm running around and doing all that stuff, but it just makes it a lot easier when you're playing. If you something happens and like, say you're at a milsim, you end up getting lost and you're wanting that to be in your YouTube video and your GoPro ends up dying, that's one of the things that normally happens, because you're not going to have enough battery life with just one battery, because like I was saying, these only have half hour battery life on them. So that's why it's nice to have the whole cord. Now, yes, you want to make sure that you have a big enough storage on your GoPro or action camera. So I have a 32 gigabyte card, which allows me to do 3 hours and 45 minutes of 1080p, and it allows me to do 1 hour of 4K. I want to start recording more in 4K. That's also one of the reasons why I did this, because 4K will literally kill your battery on your GoPro because it takes so much to run. So I might in the future be doing running 4K, I just have to get a 64 gigabyte card instead of the 32 because it has more storage, thus it has more room for 4K before, because 4K takes up a lot of storage. I've done one video on 4K and I can't remember actually which video that was, but I did a video and I rendered it in 4K, so you can actually watch that video in 4K and you can kind of see the difference. It's just since these are action cameras and not GoPros, there is a big difference with the way they record. I'm wanting to get an actual GoPro in the future just to make it a lot easier, and because I'll have the setup already, I can just get a different kit out waterproof case and make that a lot easier and make my YouTube channel just a lot better because of the quality of my video, because the qualities now aren't that good, and sometimes if you leave your YouTube on auto, it will automatically change it to, sometimes it'll do it in 1080, sometimes it may just do it in super low. So when you guys are watching my videos, actually make sure that you go to your settings and go to quality and make sure you turn it from auto to 1080 or like the highest that it'll go, because it won't affect your other videos that you're watching. It'll only affect that video, so you'll have to do it multiple times, but it just gives you a feel of what my videos look like in the highest that they record instead of what they what YouTube has for their auto. So that is going to wrap up this video, guys. Thanks so much for joining me on this video. Make sure you guys like, subscribe, and turn on post notifications. It's free. If you don't like my channel, you don't have to. Just make sure you share it with your friends, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.